Hello everyone, and welcome to our video tutorial on conditional formatting in Power BI. Before we dive into the details of conditional formatting, let's first define what it is. Conditional formatting is a feature in Power BI that allows you to format data based on specific conditions. This means that you can apply different colors, fonts, and other formatting styles to your data, depending on certain criteria. Conditional formatting can help you highlight key insights in your data and make it easier for your audience to understand and interpret your visualizations. For example, you can use conditional formatting to highlight the highest or lowest values in a column, or to highlight values that fall within a certain range. Now that we know what conditional formatting is and why it's important, let's dive into how to use it in Power BI. First, let's create a basic table visualization. To do this, we'll need to connect to a data source and select the data we want to visualize. We will use the Get Data feature to connect to our data source. In the Get Data window, we will select Excel Workbook and press Connect. Then we will select our desired file and press Open. In the Navigator window, we will select the sales table and press Load. Now wait for the data to be imported into Microsoft Power BI. Once the data is imported, the table will be displayed at the right side of the Power BI desktop. Let's add a matrix visualization to our dashboard. We will add the order type and year field to the columns area. Add the region, store, and the product field to the rows area. Finally, we will add the sales field to the values area. Now we will expand all the levels in our metrics visual for both rows and the columns. We will adjust the font size to fit the matrix to our dashboard. Font size can be adjusted from the Format Visual tab. We will adjust the font size of values to 9.5. Now that our table is ready, we can apply conditional formatting to the sales field. Conditional formatting can be accessed from the context menu of a field. There are 5 types of conditional formatting: background color, font color, data bars, icons, and web URL. Background color formatting displays the background color of a field based on a given condition. Let's display the background color of sales based on lowest and highest sales values. There are many other useful features in background color formatting, which you can use based on your requirement. Let's press OK to apply background colors based on lowest and highest values. Here the lowest values are indicated by the yellow color, and the highest values are representative by the dark red color. You can also remove the conditional formatting using the same context menu, one at a time, or all at once. Just like conditional formatting on background color, you can also define conditional formatting on the font color. Background coloring is more effective than the font color. You can also display data bars in the value fields. Mostly data bars are also used on the basis of lowest and highest values. Data bars are the small bar charts, which appear inside the value fields. You can display multiple conditional formatting at a time. For example, we have applied the data bars. Let's apply the background color formatting on the same sales value field. This is how the background color, font color, and data bars are used in conditional formatting. In the next chapter, we will learn to use the icons in conditional formatting. To apply the icon formatting, we will create a new table. We will add the year field to the rows area. The store field to the columns area. And the sales field to the values area. Now, using the context menu of the sales field, we will apply the icons formatting to the sales values. Let's add the bars indicators to the icon formatting. The lowest sales values will show 0 bars, and the maximum bars will appear before the highest sales values. You can use any set of icons from the list of icons in the conditional formatting. Finally, we will add some URLs based on conditional formatting. To apply web URLs, we will create a new table. The name of our new table will be products, and the first column of the new table will be the distinct values of product column from the sales table. Now, we will add another column for URLs. We will use the Google search URL for each product. We will replace the query string with the product name from product column. Using DAX, we have generated URL for each product. In the model view, let's create a relationship between product columns of both tables. Back to the data view, let's add the URL column, created in the products table, to the sales table. We will use the related function index, to populate the URL column in the sales table, from URL column in products table. Now, in the report view, we will use these URLs to add create web URL formatting. Select the URL field from the sales table and press OK. Each sales value is now a hyperlink with relevant product name as Google search query. Let's click on these hyperlinks and see where they take us. Each link takes us to its relevant product's Google search, just as we wanted. Finally, we will add sparklines to our table, which are closely related to the conditional for formatting. You can add sparklines, but clicking Add a Sparkline on the context menu of a values field. In the Add a Sparkline window, select the field you want to add the sparklines for, and press Create. This will add lines to your value fields, just like bars are added in the conditional formatting. We will adjust the font size of headings and values to fit the matrix visual to the dashboard. This is the end of today's Power BI exercise. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked our tutorial. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more tutorials and updates.